This is Lenny Farley, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. On this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to introduce you to another species that is just barely native to Indiana, and that is Northern Catalpa. This species sneaks into the very southern end of Indiana on the Ohio River bottoms, but has been planted much more widely because it's relatively rot resistant, so makes good fence posts and other forms of outdoor wood, and also has very attractive flower clusters in the early summer. As you can see, very large heart-shaped leaves. I'm gonna put my hand in here for a little bit of scale so you get a feel for how large those leaves get. This also has a relatively unusual leaf arrangement. And so the leaf arrangement on this species is what we call whirled. And so not only do we have opposite leaf arrangement, but we have more than two leaves at the nodes where those leaves emerge, so we get a whirl of leaves at one location on the stem. Relatively unusual in our tree species in Indiana. This species has fruit that's a very long pod that makes you think of a bean, but in fact it's not a member of the legume family, because inside that pod it holds little wing-shaped seeds that will fly away from the tree rather than beans. There are actually two species of catalpa we can run into in Indiana. One is northern, that's the one that's just barely native to our state. The other is southern, and both of them have been planted widely and are very similar. Probably the only way to really separate them is a small difference in the size of the fruit and the number and size of flowers. And both these species do produce very attractive clusters of white tubular flowers with several colors on the insides of the tubes, and so they've oftentimes been planted for ornamental purposes. Catalpas have light to medium brown to gray brown shredding bark and get to be kind of a large tree, but not very tall and oftentimes relatively spreading, particularly if they have room to grow. So a species that's been used ornamentally and also for utilitarian purposes for things like fence posts and has spread across the state much more widely than its native range, and that's Northern Catalpa.